Should you use UVA or UVB in your grow? Well, in this video, we're going to get into it. You're here with Mark Batwell at PerfectGardens.com.
Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. We got our $2.99 membership, and we have a VIP if you need a little more one-on-one, link down in the description.
I just want to say thank you so much to RIF Underground for asking the question. They were just basically asking, should you use UVA or UVB? But before we talk about that, I want to explain what these plants want to do. These plants, all they want to do throughout the entire year is prepare their seed to be able to get to the following season so that they can continue to keep growing and pushing their genetics into the future. And how do they do that, right? They do that through conditioning that seed so that it will survive the harsh winter. And what it is, one of the things it does to do that, it produces essential oils on the plant through the entire growing season, producing more or less dependent upon how harsh the growing environment is. Obviously, if the plant is grown in a healthy growing environment, in good soil, good growing nutrients, it will produce. Although the plants that are not grown in the best growing environments, how they survive is getting to producing a mature seed and coating it with its essential oils so that when the following season comes around, the seed has a chance to pop and grow and the genetics continue into the future. That being said, UVB and UVA has really an adverse effect. It stresses the plant out, and through the process of stressing the plant out, it ends up producing more essential oils. The issue with the stress with the UVA and the UVB is that you will get less yield. So which one's better, right? More yield or more essential oil? Because the market is still heavily conditioned on you getting more return on investment on yield as well as quality. Obviously, you have to get to a certain quality, but an extra 5%, 10%, 20% of essential oils on the plant, so going from, let's say, a 20% to a 24% on bag of pill when you're turning a couple pounds or more, the guy's not going to say, hey, can I check out the COA? The COA is the certificate of analysis. He's not going to pay you an extra $25 because you have a couple more terps on the plant. They're there to buy biomass. So right there, the UVA and the UVB really is going to not be for the commercial grower unless they have done metrics over time, figuring out how much more oil the plant produces with the UVA and the UVB. And again, that would really only be beneficial for extraction companies that have internal grows that are extracting all their own stuff, which no one's really doing. Especially as you take into consideration where the market's going right now. We're going more commercialized, so the cost to produce the product is heavily scrutinized in the corporate environment. It's looked at, it's measured, it's written down, and quarter after quarter, season after season, the board of directors, the CEOs, and the executive team, their commissions are normally riding on how much they can make the company or how much they can save the company in money and just the basic bottom line. So when you are able to produce more biomass in greenhouse or outdoors versus producing more oil on an indoor operation when it costs you a couple extra $100 to grow that product, when you weigh that cost, it just makes more sense to get your outdoor product, even if it is a couple more percent lower in the essential oils. A huge factor that a lot of people are missing, though, I think around the whole UVB and UVA light is instead of trying to stress the plant out, I always go back to just growing a healthier plant, giving it all of the essential minerals it needs to grow. I talk a lot about photosynthesis. When the light comes down and hits the leaves, it creates a spectrum. Well, what is comprised of that spectrum, or how is that spectrum made, right? And it's made because of all of the minerals that are stored in the leaves, and the light hits those leaves and all of those minerals that are in the little cell pockets of those leaves, the light comes down and it reflects off, and then you have this very unique spectrum of light. Well, if you're only pumping your plants full of NPK, that spectrum, in my viewpoint, will be very limited. That's why I'm always pushing trace minerals, right? A product called Drops of Balance, making your water clean, increasing that trace minerals because of something called the law of minimum and the law of tolerance, getting your bioavailability or your biodynamics in your soil going, and then grow after grow, re-amending your soil with good, healthy amendments that actually feed the microbiology. Getting to a point where your soil is healthy and alive, and getting to the point where you've gotten away from synthesized man-made nutrients 100% and you're going back to a biodynamic living soil. If you're a grower that just had maybe a 3x3 or 4x4 tent and wanted to play around with these lights, go ahead. Just be prepared though that the plants will probably end up yielding a little less. They might have a little bit more essential oils because the plant is going through more stress because you're providing light that is normally blocked through the atmosphere. Okay, so also really just take that into consideration too. When you're growing indoors, why are we growing indoors? Where did this industry start? It started because of the prohibition of these plants. We had to grow indoors because if we didn't, it could have costed us years of our life. Now that we're going through the decriminalization and the legalization of this industry, us getting rid of the old mindset and going back to more of a traditional mindset or a natural mindset of using the outdoor light and getting conditioned to growing outdoors. It is what is going to keep the small growers alive and is going to keep it out of the corporate hands. I'm not against corporations and I'm not against centralizing workload. What I'm against is the disconnection that happens when we lose our connection to the earth. The value of these plants because of the criminalization of them, it has kept a lot of people connected to growing plants that I think otherwise wouldn't have because they would have just ended up getting a job or going and doing something else. I would also say that the UVA and the UVB, you can get very similar experiences by using LEDs now. The UVA and the UVB mindset really has been around since 30, 40, 50 years ago when it was printed in the Grow Bible. And it's just, again, one of those things that I think distracts a grower from getting profitable in this industry. Because there is so much value in growing these plants, literally by the per gram basis, all these little ideas of, oh, you could do this and you could do that to get a better yield and do that, have come out over the course of the last 50 to 70 years. And I would just encourage all of you guys to not get distracted. Especially if you want to be competitive or if you ever think about actually doing this as a business. The time of being able to be creative is really starting to fade because a lot of the times being creative is expensive. And the profit margins that used to be in this industry, that used to be able to pay for people's time to be creative, really isn't there anymore. And again, if you're just doing a 3x3 or 4x4, play around with it. Enjoy your time. If you want to do something, go ahead and do it. Although, if you want to learn how to perfect these plants and perfect your growing techniques, then evolve yourself around the business side of things, then I would probably suggest not wasting your time on this stuff. Focus in on growing healthy plants. Give good, clean water. Give all the essential trace minerals you need. Control the heat. Don't let it get too cold. Don't let your pots dry out and develop healthy, good relationships around you. You do all those things, I can almost guarantee you, you're going to keep enjoying your time while growing these plants and you'll continue to keep developing yourself over time. I hope this video was helpful. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks so much, guys.
Is it normal that if you took a clone and put it side by side with a plant that was from seed, I think from seed, you're going to get a lot more production out of it than you would the clone. And is that a thing?